nothing to be worried about. You're a smart woman with a strong moral compass. You just need to think your way out of it. Oh, fudge!
They can fly, yeah.
What's she doing?
I think she's spouting euphemism, Tadas. Luckily, the road out of Hill Valley is still pretty rough in 1875. It's unlikely she'll manage to accelerate 88 miles an hour anytime soon.
How are we gonna stop her?
Good question. We can't risk injuring her or damaging the vehicle for fear of altering the timeline even further. Luckily, those diagnostic lights, my alternate self, went all over DeLorean, have given me an idea. Here, take these.
What are these?
Flux synchronization modules.
How do they work?
I generally use them for maintenance purposes, but we might be able to use them to sync up with the alternate DeLorean's diagnostic modules, thus making it possible to link both sets of time units and override the time destination of the alternate DeLorean. At least that's the theory, anyway.
That's a great plan. I think.
That's a theory.
Best of all, we won't need well the
modules. A game theory.
Snap them over the diagnostic lights.
Wait a minute, Doc. You want me to go out there? How the heck am I supposed to do that?
Good question. Let me think. Aha!
A hoverboard!
It saved our hides a few times before, so it seemed like the appropriate tool to bring along for the job.
Sweet!
Okay.
You okay?
It's just like riding a bike.
You ready to make the jump?
Ready, Doc.
1, 2, 3, jump!
Whoa.
Nice form, Marty. How's the reception on the wireless?
Great. Where'd you get these?
From Bird's cache of 21st century video game consoles. Now remember, all you've got to do is attach the flux sync modules to those diagnostic lights.
Will do, Doc.
The other two. Oh, there's one up there.
Is that one of the flux emitters?
Yes. Now plug in the flux sink.
I can't reach it from here.
We just have to climb onto the top.
It's locked. Mr. Fusion, should I disable it?
Leave it alone. Not a good idea to monkey with nuclear reactors.
Mr. Fusion!
I don't know how to climb.
I can't reach it from here.
Go to the front. Okay, that's a very good point actually. I didn't think about that.
Doc,
Okay, she broke her bumper, I guess.
Don't cross those flames, they may be radioactive.
I don't even like crossing through normal flames.
Really? Alright.
It's locked! I'm okay.
Yeah, I'm completely stuck now because both of my options are down the drain now. Okay.
I can't reach it from here.
A reach extender? What the fuck? Okay. So. She could just see me.
Now let's get that bunch of dry mouse warm before she starts making life difficult.
She's been making it easy up till now? Well, here goes nothing, Doc. Whoa!
Perfect! Now, aim the buck sink towards the receiving dish on my DeLorean.
Receiving dish. Check!
Okay, that moves way too fast, for real. Okay, now I don't know actually how to climb. Oh, really?
Edna!
What?
Let me in!
You want in? Fine!
Marty! Are you all right?
Not really.
What?
Pull over.
No.
You're in a lot of danger.
So are you.
Give it up.
You first.
Not sure what that'll do.
I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. Oh, really? Oh, look at that pixel, hun. I can't even see that.
Excellent, Marty. Now that you're on top of the DeLorean, you can attach the plug sink to the overhead plug emitter.
That's great, Doc.
Nicely
done. Now, aim the sink toward the receiving dish. Okay, this is gonna be really hard. Okay. Nicely done, Doc.
they take control of that little oil with the flux synchronizers now? That's strange.
What?
According to these readings, the temporal cohesion of Edna's DeLorean is decaying at an alarming rate.
English, Doc.
We've got to get Edna home. Now!
Is that the police station? Looks like the police station.
Parker? Then I must be back in... Would you be kind enough to tell me what day it is?
It's the day I place you under arrest for arson, resisting arrest, and being a general all-round pain in the ass.
No! You can't arrest me! Not now, I just got back from the last century.
Oh, would you look at that? Edna Strickland, drunk as a skunk.
I'm not drunk, you reprobate. I'm a time traveler.
Sure you are. I'm loving this.
I'll prove it to you. Come with me. We can do the whole day over if you want. We can fix everything.
We can start by drying you out. Come on, into the station with you.
You can bunk with me, doll.
I'd rather die. Stop it. Unhand me, you dolt.
Wow.
Well, I guess that's it for Edna.
Yes, I suppose it is. You know, whoever said time heals all wounds didn't know a squat about time travel.
What do we do about that, DeLorean?
No need to do a thing. Ever since we synced up the time circuits, the temporal breakdown in Edna's DeLorean has accelerated at an exponential rate. By my calculations, the timeline should catch up with it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, now!
What the hell? Hey, Parker, you're not gonna believe this!
See? What did I say? Ready to go home?
Wait, Doc! The timeline's not fixed yet. Look!
Sonny! You missed all the fireworks at the expo!
Yeah, so I heard. Listen, I heard a rumor about you two.
I guess we gotta come clean. Ta-da! Hottie took me to Reno last night!
Try to keep a secret in Hill Valley.
Well, you gonna congratulate us or what?
Then it's true. My grandpa's married the wrong grandma. I'm done for.
Hey, you feeling all right, kid? You don't look so hot.
I don't want to say any of these, but sure.
Artie, you can't do this. You're not supposed to get married for another 5 years.
Well, I know Trixie and I were taking things slow.
But after that witch Edna got me fired with that postcard, we kind of accelerated things a little.
The postcard? Oh, man. This just isn't right.
Now, I know marrying a Canadian for a work permit isn't strictly by the book, but hey, sometimes you gotta go out on a limb for the ones you love.
Isn't he just the sweetest?
Can you see through me?
Nope. Never could figure you out. I thought you'd be thrilled for us.
You don't understand. You're supposed to marry Sylvia Miskin.
But I did marry Sylvia Miskin.
What?
You didn't think my real name was Trixie Trotta, did ya?
Wow.
Don't feel too bad. It was kind of a surprise to me, too.
Wait a minute. You're Grandma Sylvie?
Grandma? Hey, how old do you think I am, kiddo?
But you're so... skinny and blonde and
I've
seen you naked. You're Sylvia?
You okay, pal?
Yeah, I'm fine. Great. You kids go off and have yourself a wonderful honeymoon. And don't worry about your dad, Artie. I'm sure he'll come around.
Come around to what?
To approving your marriage. You seem kind of mad about it back at the high school.
Well, that was before I got a look at her. Besides, as my dear old father Seamus used to say, no sense in getting riled up over something I can't do nothing about. And honestly, now that I met her,
I can't imagine a better daughter-in-law than the charming Miss Sylvie here.
Aw, thank you, Dad.
As for you, stranger, I'll thank you to not go poking your nose in McFly family business.
It's been a pleasure, Agent Crockett.
See you in the funny paper, Sonny.
Wow. What a development.
You know, I took some pictures of Trixie in 1931.
Hey, that's my grandma you're talking about.
Wow. Very funny. Slightly different timeline where Doc has the key to the city.
Here we are, back in good old 1986.
May 14th?
15th. Best to build in a little lag time. Gives you a chance to catch up.
Looks like the estate sale is still going on. Hey, don't you want to stay, Doc? You gotta stop the bank from selling off all your old stuff.
What are you talking about? Estate sale? Bank? I'm not dead, Marty. Clara and I are having a little garage sale, that's all.
Garage sale? You mean... Marty, you're back from your trip. Hello, Doc. Selling off the family treasures, eh?
Not quite, but I hope you find something you like.
Speaking of which, did you find what you were looking for? Yeah, I sure did. Great! Hey, is that a box of Asimov? Let me get this straight. Are you telling me you live here now? In 1986?
Well, naturally. Claire and I maintain a part-time residence here. Wasn't that the case when you left?
No.
Strange. I can't imagine not sticking around. After all, I've got my late father's foundation to supervise. If I wasn't here, who'd present the annual Earhart Brown Scholarship for Young Scientists?
Wow.
Something funny?
I'll explain it to you later.
It's a bit different.
I don't see what's so funny about looking after a family legacy. Oh, almost forgot. I've got something for you.
Hmm.
Happy graduation.
Graduation? But that's not for another... The McFlys of Hill Valley.
An exhaustively detailed history of your family. From your great-great-grandfather Seamus to the present.
You traveled through time to write this?
Well, most of the research was done traditionally, but your grandma Sylvia proved to be something of a mystery.
Which is why you traveled back to 1931, to look for her.
Exactly. Who knew she was singing in a speakeasy under her stage name?
This is great, Doc. Thanks.
It's the least I can do for the man who saved me from making the worst mistake of my life.
Yoo-hoo! Dr. Brown!
Oh my god.
Einie!
What's going on? What are you doing on my door?
The same thing I do every afternoon, silly man. Giving him such much needed exercise. Isn't that right, Einstein?
Hey, dollface, it's past time for our 3:30.
Oh my god.
Coming, sweetie! Oh, Mr. McFly, have you seen my stepson anywhere?
Oh, Biff, I think you're late for an appointment.
Oh, gosh, you're right, Mr. McFly.
Hi, Marty.
Don't they make a great little family? You'd never know they met in prison.
Oh, my God.
Don't say anything. Let's just walk quietly into the lab and hope there are no more surprises.
Whoa, that's funny. That's really funny. Oh, that's great. Okay.
Doc!
Marty! What are you doing here?
You gotta come with me! Back to the future!
Marty, you can't be here! If your younger self sees you, the consequences could be catastrophic!
My younger self? Oh, right! Bring him along, too! This concerns all of us! What do you mean? Does something happen to us?
Do we turn into assholes or something?
Nah, we're fine. But our great-great-grandkids? What the hell?
Great Scott!
What the fuck? Why is that one blue?
Doc, you gotta come back with me. Back to
Don't
the-
listen to him, Doc. It's me you gotta help. If you wanna save Jennifer and our 12 kids.
What? That timeline was overwritten 5 jumps back.
Doc, Jennifer's out of how can there be 2 more of me here?
I have no idea. My own rights of space-time continuum should be tearing apart like a cheap dish rag right now.
It already is. What my evil twin and I are trying to say is the future is totally jacked up, and you gotta come with me to save it. No, me!
Who is this?
So, we meet at last. You've altered my timeline once too often.
What's going on, Doc?
Well, we do seem to have a conundrum on our hands. Or 3.
Yeah, Doc, but which one is the real me?
Isn't it obvious, Marty? Come on!
Prepare to be erased. Doc, wait! What about the space-time continuum?
Yeah, what about my future? And mine?
The future can wait. We've got a present to catch up with.
What a weird...
Where to, Doc?
Mr. McFly, thrill me.
Wow, okay. It's like the movie end, huh? Okay. That was nice, actually. That was a really nice way of sort of extending it. That was cool. Wow. That was so cool. Man, that was great. That was a great game. I can't believe we're done with it. You know, it's been pretty much a year since we started. We started last year, back in like August. End of August, maybe? Something. Maybe. Not even end of August. It was like... It was summer. I can check, but I'm pretty sure it's a year. That's crazy. Although, to give you guys some context, it's currently the 12th of August right now, when I just finished this. This probably won't make it to YouTube till, what, let's see. September, end of October-ish? Which is kind of crazy. So if you're watching this end of October, yeah, this was recorded back in August. I'd have a German cast for all the different, yeah. But yeah, it was something, that's for sure. So Trixie was Sylvia. That's very funny. Funny how that works. Back in time, yeah. Man, 86. Crazy. You know, I gotta rewatch these movies eventually, because I think that it'd be cool to see again with the context of this game in mind as well. Little Telltale Pets, Nitro T1, Monster Mash, some interesting names. Synchronous video game with video team or film. Oh, that's interesting. this came out 2011. This is 70 years old as well, this game. Very funny. Well, anyway, thank you so much for watching. This was Back to the Future. I don't know how it's gonna go from here on out when this finishes, and Renegade's probably already finished. I don't know if there's any new series coming out or not. If there are, well, just, I guess, I don't know. Hooray. But if they're not, well, it's been fun. And I definitely enjoy doing these series for YouTube and everything. But I'm gonna go. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, everyone. And I'll see you all next time. Bye.